Welcome to the second episode of LDOE Log, an informational series all about Last Day on Earth. And this episode is all about getting steel. You need steel to craft metal walls for your base, to make a military backpack, or even to upgrade to rack storage inside of your base. It's got plenty of other applications as well, and we're going to be taking a look at the most efficient ways you can get your hands on it. So you need lots of aluminum and copper to get steel. You also need charcoal and iron, but we're going to be focusing on aluminum and copper because they're a bit more difficult to get. Now you can get them by completing mid to high level content, you can mine for their ores outright, or you can pop some items in the recycler and hope that you get lucky. Now, when you're completing mid to high level content, you'll probably be burning through quite a few guns. To mine the ore, you'll need quite a bit of time, and to recycle items, you'll need to collect very specific items for the recycling process. So let's take a look at getting aluminum first, then we'll take a look at copper, and then at steel. So hands down, Bunker Alpha is the most efficient way to get lots of aluminum in Last Day on Earth. As you're running through these levels, you'll come across all these chests, and it's a good idea to go and open as many as you can, and you'll get a lot of aluminum wire in these chests most of the time. Now, aluminum wire can then be smelted into aluminum bars, which are the precursor to steel bars. Now, once you've collected aluminum wires, you can come over to the furnaces, and it will take two of them to craft one aluminum bar. So, from running floor 2 and floor 3 of Bunker Alpha, these aren't even full clears of the floors, I usually get around 9 aluminum wires. Now that's really good, and while you're playing Bunker Alpha, you'll also collect coupons. And these coupons can be exchanged for crates that often have a good amount of aluminum wire inside of them. I skipped running through there and have the totals here. As you can see, we got a great amount. We actually got some aluminum bars outright, but I converted their number into the aluminum wires just to give you an overall view of that. So Bunker Alpha, hands down, the best way. So you could also opt to mine iron ore deposits for a chance of them dropping bauxite, which is a precursor to aluminum. However, this cannot be done in the green and yellow limestone areas, just the red. And for the best chance of getting bauxite drops, you'd want to mine inside the red winter zone area. However, before doing this, I would just recommend recycling cans and hoping to get aluminum bars. And over both of those, Bunker Alpha is still the king of getting aluminum. Just be patient and run that as often as you can, and you'll have heaps of aluminum in no time. So now that we've covered aluminum, we'll take a look at copper, and we'll start off with the recycler because this is actually a really efficient way to get lots of copper bars. As you can see, cameras have a 10% chance, gold watches give us a 5% chance, and batteries are the most efficient item to recycle for copper with a 15% chance. Now keep in mind that your recycler level for each of these categories corresponds with the percentage chance of the drop. So my electronics is at max and my other is at 12. So if I'm recycling another item, my drop rate chances are going to be lower, but my electronics have the best chances. Let's say your electronics level is a bit lower, you can level it up by recycling unimportant items and then recycling more important items for that higher drop rate chance. Now we'll head on back to Bunker Alpha and take a look. By completing these floors in Bunker Alpha, we also get a decent amount of batteries and watches, which can also be recycled for that copper. So Bunker Alpha is not only a great primary source for aluminum, it's also a great secondary source for getting copper, and you should be running it every 2 days and trying to get as efficient at it as you can. And another way to get copper is to mine for its precursor, copper ore, in the winter zones. Now this does get a bit tedious because you'll be doing quite a bit of planning and you'll need lots of fur armor because the winter zones are a bit cold. And fur armor does not come cheap, so it is really recommended that you spend some time planning out your copper runs for this area. You'll also need iron pickaxes because copper ore requires the iron pickaxe and it takes 10 picks to break one pile of copper ore. So definitely not a cheap process, and it costs 71 energy to get to the yellow northern region. So once you're up there, I would really suggest planning to stay there for a while. Take your motorbike, pack a lot of iron pickaxes, and then once you get there, you're going to want to stick to the outside of the region. Don't head in yet, just scout for the easy ore on the outskirts, because you really want to be avoiding the zombies up here as they are particularly difficult. So just head around the outside, and then once you've cleared all those, then you can head to the inside. Remember, some battles are not worth fighting, so here we've got a lot of zombies, and it's just really not worth that one ore, because they're going to be doing a lot of damage to our fur armor. And it is worth mentioning that these zombies heal when they hit you. However, I did find with a fully modded mace, I am able to sneak attack one shot the biters here. So that is an option if you do have that item. And you'll want to keep a safe distance away from the frozen bloaters up here because they take forever to kill. Attacking them is definitely not a good idea. Just wait for them to move around if they're blocking an ore deposit, and they'll eventually wander off. So once you get up here, you'll just bounce back and forth between these two winter zones until you have as much copper as you can carry. This is also an opportunity to use up any rations that you have to auto-clear these zones, and you can get rations as a free-to-play player in some of the season passes. So this is what I usually use my rations on. And when you get home, you can melt down 5 of those copper ores into 1 copper bar. So that finishes up copper, and now we'll move on to steel. And as you can see here, we have the top recipe being for steel bars. It requires iron, charcoal, aluminum, and copper. I usually keep all of my steel items in one chest, so it's easy to get started in the crafting process. And once we've collected all those items, we'll head on over to the refined melting furnace. So as you can probably tell, the most intensive part of this process is learning how to farm aluminum and copper the most efficiently. After that, steel is pretty easy. Now, you could also decide to roll the dice and hope that you get lucky with the recycler and recycle some of these higher level items to get steel bars outright. And I've actually gotten quite a few bars from that method. So throughout this video, we've been using a lot of charcoal, and just as an aside, I thought I'd tell you the most efficient way to get charcoal in the game, because it is a pretty important part of this whole process. So you put 8 charcoal on the bottom, 10 planks on the top, and that is hands down the most efficient way to get your hands on lots of charcoal. Just a quick little aside there. And that wraps up this episode of LDOE Log. Thanks so much for watching. If you're looking for more Last Day on Earth content, I write a lot of Last Day on Earth articles over on PressingX.com. And if you're looking for more of this series, I'd recommend checking out the LDOE Log playlist, where I have the previous episodes, and the future ones will be added there as well. Again, thank you so much for watching, and have a great day.